Get in there, oil. Oh shit, oh shit. Oh my God. What the hell is that? We got parts, guys, from Honda Parts now. Open it up. Hey, Brittany.
You're so lame. I don't want to be in your stupid vlog. Whatever the hell it's called.
All right, let's open this up. Parts. There's a seal. There is some manual trans fluid. I'm just gonna go ahead and lay all this out. Okay, so here's what I got. I'm missing another one of these seals. I ordered two of them. I'll see if I can get my money back for that because I actually don't need it. It was for the white car, but that's actually not leaking. I thought it was. But this is a trans shift linkage seal. Here's an axle seal, driver side for the EG. Some Honda Bond. Oil pan gasket for the EG, and some trans fluid. Now, the reason I buy this stuff from Honda, or from Honda dealership parts, OEM parts, is because I don't want to have to replace it twice. I've done that way too many times. You go to Advance Auto, AutoZone, whatever your local auto parts store is, you buy that Felpro, Dayco, Dahlco, whatever the hell you want to call it, bullshit. And you put it in, you replace your rear main seal with one of their seals, you know, with your trans out and everything, put it all back together, drive it for 1,000 miles, realize that it's still leaking and have to take it out again, your entire transmission. So that stuff is fine when you're doing like valve cover gaskets, I guess oil pan gasket if you don't mind doing it again, even though that sucks. Just stuff that you can get to easily. Otherwise, just get the OEM stuff, you don't have to worry about it leaking, just peace of mind. And yeah, all this stuff is for the EG. Gotta see if I get my money back for this missing shift linkage seal there. All right. What's going on, guys? Today we're working on the EG, the Black Turd, AKA Amanda the Handa. And today I got my boy Bert with me. What's up,
yeah.
Bert?
Yeah.
What up?
What's up, okay. YouTube?
And, okay, so today I'm doing a bunch of seals and stuff. I got the wheel off already. That's all I've done so far. So we'll go ahead and get started.
What's up, YouTube? He wants me to grab this chair and come under there.
Are you going to say what's up, YouTube, every single time you turn it on?
Yeah, I think so. It's my first YouTube.
All right, let's go. All
right.
Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do is drain the trans fluid, if I can get this out. I just did this recently, so. Gonna be like none in there because it's all been leaking out.
That's some dirty shit right there.
What are you talking about? I just put that in there, dude.
Yeah, look at that.
So if we come over here, you can see that everything is covered in oil. And that is because everything is leaking. So the oil pan's leaking. Jeez. This axle seal over here is leaking. This shift linkage seal right here, if I can get the light on it, right there, is leaking. I can't even focus it, but. And then this oil pan, or not this oil pan, this is my new steering rack, but there was a power steering rack in here that was pouring out fluid as well. So basically this whole car was just leaking. So now I'm taking care of that, and it's gonna hopefully have no leaks when I'm done.
See that? Clear. Mean.
Ew. Fucking spider nest in here.
What?
There's like a spider nest in here.
I ain't going fast enough.
What, are you recording again?
I am.
I gotta get this axle nut, or this piece, to come out of there so I can take the axle nut off, and I don't have a screwdriver small enough, apparently.
You know what is small enough?
Your dick.
A smaller screwdriver.
Huh? A smaller screwdriver?
That's working.
I just need like a punch.
There we go, maybe.
One more size bigger to do it. Alright. Yeah, 32mm socket.
That's a big socket. How's it feel in your hands?
Jesus, dude. Feels great. Because I just put this in like a couple weeks ago, so yeah, it's ready to come out. Okay, next you gotta take the ball joint out. I don't have a cotter pin in there.
Not sure why.
That's all right.
That's gonna need the hammer as well.
You just bang it loose. Bang it loose, dude.
Not banging on it too hard because it should come right out. Yeah. Because I just had this apart, like I said.
There it is. It's out.
Okay. Let's see. So I have a new boot for that ball joint.
I've got a new boot.
So, these, I got these online. Pretty sweet. They are, for improved handling, control for street, track, and off-road. Better than new performance OE parts.
What is this?
And,
what is this?
I don't know, some shit that I bought on eBay.
What is it?
The best upgrade money can buy. This is a, these are ball joint and tie rod end boots for this car.
Well, what does that do?
They just replace your cracked boots. Apparently this is like some kind of suspension upgrade, but they're just ball joint boots, so.
Best money can buy.
According to this, best money can buy. Best upgrade money can buy. I don't know if I agree with that.
What's up, YouTube?
What's going on? So, finished this ball joint here. And I got the new boot on. And I'm really, really excited to see what it's going to be like handling around turns and stuff. I have a feeling this car is going to handle way better. Perfect for the track.
Like 15 horsepower.
I'd recommend these ball joint boots for anybody looking to replace their ball joint boots for no reason at all. Or if they're ripped, then I guess that would work too. But anyway, so next we're gonna start taking off the exhaust and just to make room so I can put the axle seal in. So I'll start doing that now. The wrong way.
I like the way you move your arms.
Ooh, okay. It's a surprise inside. And it smells like E85.
So your exhaust leaking?
Huh?
that stuff coming out of your exhaust?
Just water. Oh. Uh-oh.
What do you gotta do?
Take this off. I don't have to take it off, but I don't feel like fighting with the header, so I'm going to.
Alright, save time. We're gonna take off this plastic underpiece. Surprised you didn't have that ripped off already anyway.
You can pause it. And a few of them. Let's go. Uh-oh. We have to find that.
Taking off the header?
Uh-huh.
Seriously?
Yeah, but that is super important. Jesus Christ, dude.
What's going on, YouTube?
What's going on, guys? So, about to take the header out now that I got all the bolts done, except for the ones underneath. They're going to fall out. Disconnected the O2 sensors. It's dripping water everywhere. Oil all over it. Holy shit, dude. Alright then. Alright, so next the axle has to come out and I need Rob's help for that, so I won't be able to record it. But we'll go ahead and pull that out really quick. I forgot that before you have to take out the axle, you have to take off this fork right here for the suspension. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that really quick. So we got that one. All right, got the axle out. So we're gonna call it a night and pick back up tomorrow. Rob won't be here.
Maybe.
But, well, I mean, unless he wants to come over and help again. This is his car. It is the E46 325. I can't even see it. But it's nice.
What's up, y'all? So I took out this axle seal right here. I took it out from over here. I just popped it out with a screwdriver. So I'm going to go ahead and put in this new one that I got in the mail and call it good. I got the seal in the transmission now. Next, I'm gonna move on to this seal right here. It needs to be replaced. It's actually underneath this boot. But first, we have to undo this shift linkage, which right here, you can see there's a pin in there that has to come out. So I actually have to punch that out with a punch and a hammer, and then after I get that out, I can separate the shift linkage. Well, I pulled this boot off of the shift linkage. I got the shift linkage down here and took the seal out. It was in there and I just popped it out with a screwdriver. Now I'm gonna go ahead and hammer in the new seal. Probably gonna use like a 15 or 16 millimeter socket to get that on there. But I gotta go get the new seal out of the packaging. New shift linkage seal is on. All I have to do is put the boot back on and slip the shift linkage back on there and pop that, put the pin back in. And that'll be ready to go. Okay, so this is back in. I don't know what this brown colored stuff is on here. But it's like, it was coming out of the trans and stuff. I don't know what he had in here before. But picture think of the nastiest dump you've ever taken. Like that smell, and then multiply it by 12, and that is what this smells like. So I don't know what it is, but it's definitely not Honda manual trans fluid. It's disgusting. But it's all back together now and hopefully not leaking out anymore. And we'll go ahead and continue from here. Not sure what I'm gonna do next today. I do want to take out the oil pan before I put the axle in. That has like tons of RTV all over it. Hopefully I don't have to do the same thing. I had to do it in my other car, like cake the whole gasket and RTV because it just kept leaking when I was doing it. But this time I got a Honda gasket, so we'll see what happens with that.
What up, butt farts? We're on day 3 of the Black Turd vlog. This is why my dad doesn't let me use his garage, because I do boring stuff that I don't feel like finishing, and then I spend 3 to 4 days working on it. And yeah, so let's begin.
Time for the oil pan to come off. I'm gonna go ahead and drain this oil. I already broke this loose with a ratchet, so maybe not. Okay, now it's time to start taking these bolts and nuts off. That one must not have been important, I guess. Right there in the corner. But I gotta take all these out, and then I should be able to drop the oil pan, so I guess that one wasn't important either. Looks like I might be going to a junkyard to get some nuts and bolts. I just realized some of you might be wondering why the flywheel is exposed here. There's supposed to be an inspection plate that covers that. That is just completely missing. It's been missing since I got the car. Obviously, probably not too good for the clutch, especially if oil is getting up in there. After this, oil won't be getting up in there, but I should probably try to get one of those from a junkyard as well, because that's pretty stupid that that's not on there. It's not like it falls off either. They just, whoever had this car before me, just never put it back on.
All right, y'all, we got that gasket off. It's in the garbage, and the oil pan's off, obviously, if we got the gasket off. But gotta peel this RTV off of here that was completely caked on. The gasket was ripped in a whole bunch of spots, so that's probably why it was leaking. So I'll peel this off, maybe take the oil pan and power wash it, and put the new gasket on and put it back together.
What's up, dudes? I got this oil pan gasket in. Now I gotta go ahead and change that oil filter up there, which is the worst location for an oil filter ever. I didn't power wash the oil pan because it's already dark again, and that sucks. So it's just because I get off work late, so I'm just gonna go ahead and start taking this little dude off right here. Hopefully it's not on too tight and I can get off with my hand. Oh, it's on too tight. Let me get a better grip. Oh, who put this on? Oh yeah, it was me. I got it. I got it. It's coming. Slowly but surely. There it is. Look at that. All right, I'll go ahead and take this out and put the new one in.
Yo, yo, check it out. Got that good. We ready for some new fluids. Only the best of the best. JK Dog, I got some Meyer brand oil. Only reason I bought it is because my car was leaking oil so bad and I didn't want to run anything but synthetic. I run synthetic in all my cars. And so I bought the cheapest stuff because I was just going through it. But I got like 4 quarts of this stuff, so enough to do an oil change. I'm not going to let it go to waste, so I'm just going to go ahead and pour that in.
Oh yeah, look at that. Ooh, look at it go. Oh yeah. Get in there, oil. Oh shit, oh shit.
What do you mean use a funnel? What's a funnel?
Here we are, it's another day, and here's what I come out to.
So, properly installing an oil pan, putting Honda bond in the correct spots using a Honda oil pan gasket does not make a difference. These oil pans are just meant to leak. So that's just from sitting from last night when I filled it up till now. So I guess I'm just gonna take the whole oil pan back off, cake the entire gasket in Honda bond, and put it back up there. That's exactly what I had to do on that car to get it to stop leaking as well. So, pain in the butt, but I guess that's what you gotta do. I got the new oil pan, or the oil pan gasket on again. This time I put a bead of RTV around the whole entire thing
between the oil pan and the gasket, and then between the gasket and the block. So hopefully it doesn't leak. It probably still will a little bit. On this side, I think the oil pan's bent. You can kind of see it there. So that's probably why it was leaking yesterday. But yeah, hopefully we're good now. What's up, Homo sapiens? I got my buddy AJ here with me.
What up?
He's gonna help me out with putting the axle back in and putting everything back together.
Let's do it.
What's up, YouTube? We got the axle in and I put the fork back in. Now I'm gonna go ahead and tighten the axle nut. That's supposed to be like 200 foot-pounds or something like that. So just tighten it way down and then make sure to hammer this notch back in and it's good to go. Next it's time for that guy to go in. We need both of us to put it in, so I'm not gonna be able to record it, but we'll do that now. Got some new juices for the Civic, so we're gonna go ahead and fill it up.
Hi, Mom!
Oh, watch out. Watch yourself.
I'm glad I backed up as much as I did before that happened.
Okay. Still in the hole, right?
Yeah, I'm not seeing any leaks. Back at it again with the Meyer oil.
Oh no, I spilled it again. Back at it again with the Meyer oil. It looks really gross the second time through. Good. What's up, guys? So basically what happened was I finished working on the car with AJ, and we took it for a test drive. We got back, there's still tons of oil pouring out, and it's coming from the rear main seal. So unfortunately I'm gonna have to drop the trans. I'm gonna replace the clutch while I'm doing it, but that's gonna be the end of this video, and we'll go ahead and continue with that on the next video. Thanks for watching. Aw, damn. Look at that sexy bitch. Aw, yeah.